and to map the date and the attendance from their initial data values to an actual pixel value, we use D3's scale function. One thing that we haven't seen before is how to deal with time in D3. Notice, rather than just using D3.scale, we're first going into the D3.time module and then calling the scale function contained within. For our attendance, or our count scale, since attendance is an integer, we can directly use D3.scale and then use a linear function within. And for both the time scale and the count scale, the domain we're mapping from is the minimum and maximum dates, in this case, the time extent. For the attendance, it's the minimum and maximum attendance, in this case, count extent, which get mapped into the range for the x-axis, the margin to the width, so basically the leftmost part of our chart and the rightmost part of our chart. And for the y-axis, the quirk of SVG, where it has an inverted coordinate plane, a y value of 0 is actually at the top of the web page. And as the y value increases, you go down the page. So in this case, the minimum value of attendance starts at the height of our chart, so at the very bottom, and it goes up into the top of the chart, in this case, margin.